Hi there, my name is Dan. Now there are loads of videos here like this one on my channel, but if you want more, check out my website, bringyourownlaptop.com. Hi there, in this video we're going to look at swinging ticks. It's kind of just a cool motion graphics-y thing. Can you see the swing ticks sliding down? Okay, I did it for in front of a few of my tutorials a while ago. So we're going to do that. Alright, so first thing we need to do is create a new composition. Okay, I'm going to have a white background. I know it doesn't export well, but I'm just going to make it white anyway. I'm going to make sure mine's 5 seconds long. Okay, and click OK. Great, so we've got a comp. I'm going to make this a little smaller. Click and drag. Here we go. Alright, I'm going to grab my type tool. I'm going to click once. And I'm going to type in Daniel. It's better in this one to use uppercase. Lowercase ends up with bits kind of dangling out and doesn't really look great. So I'm going to use this. And there's a couple of things I need to do is I don't want you to do that, put a return in and start working on this trick. So I'm going to use the top name, add another line, and I'm going to use three. Okay, I'm going to use my first, middle, and last names. I want them to all be on their own three layers. Okay, so there's the first one. I'm going to maybe make that one a big weighty 900. Okay, and then I'm going to click this, copy and paste, Control C, Control V. I'm going to drag it down. Okay, I'm going to double click it, put in my middle name, make sure it's in uppercase. Uppercase off, select the text, put this one as a real light one, it's about the right size. Okay, and then I'm going to duplicate it again, click Walter, copy paste, drag it down. Holding shift while I drag gets it into a straight line. Okay, and then I'm gonna select this and make this the 500 one. And then I'm gonna go to the font size just to make it kind of match up for no good reason. Drag it down a little bit. Okay, the next thing we need to do is change the like point of origin or the anchor point. At the moment, it's down here at the bottom. It just means if I grab Scott and I twirl it down and I grab transform and I grab rotation, where is he? There he is. Okay, it rotates around there. I want it to swing from the top down. So we're gonna have to play with that. So I'm gonna tool it all back up. And also just to make it make more sense, I put Daniel at the top and Walter in the middle. Let's go to the bottom, just so it matches there and there so I don't get confused. So I'm gonna click on Daniel layer. I'm gonna grab my anchor point tool, okay, or the pan behind tool. I'm gonna drag the center. And if you hold down member command on a Mac, you can snap it to the top or control on a PC. Do it for all of them, okay. Try and get it to the top of these guys. Try not to get them to snap to something else. Try and get them to snap to themselves. Right, so that's the anchor points done. Next thing I need to do, I need to make them 3D. Because at the moment, if I click on Daniel, twirl it down, transform. At the moment, it can rotate, but only kind of like that way. I want it to rotate backwards. So all we need to do is I'm going to twirl it up. I'm going to make this a bit taller. Okay, and these three need to come on. I'm clicking and dragging across them all. It's a good way to turn them all on, all off. Or you can just click them all three of them on. Now it's going to be 3D. Okay, you don't have to have a camera to make them 3D. It just means we can't animate the camera and move it around. Okay, but we are going to get all the good stuff we need in terms of all this extra data. Watch on, off. Okay, you get a lot more. The one we want to deal with is X rotation. If you find yours is doing some weird stuff, it's probably because you've used orientation. It does work, but if you try and spin it around, it tries to take the shortest distance. So even though you want it to swing back and forward, it'll go over the top. Okay. So just make sure you're using X rotation. And to start here, I'm going to click on X rotation. Awesome. Get my first keyframe. And I'm gonna not use the first zero. I'm gonna use the 0.0 degrees. And I'm gonna swing it back. So drag it back and forth, just get a feel what it does. And hey, it's already looking pretty cool. So let's just animate that. So I'm gonna swing it back, kind of back past there. So that's my first keyframe. Move it along, how far? About half a second. And I'm gonna swing it. Oh, not that way, that way. So it kind of swings past where I want it to go. How far past? It's up to you. Yeah, looks good to me. Okay, and a bit further along now. It's gonna depend on the size of your comp and the size of your font and all sorts of other things to know how far these keyframes should be apart to get the swinging going. So don't copy me exactly. I'm at 20 frames. You might have to play with something else, but I'm just a little bit further along. How many degrees? There's gonna be a little bit playing around. I've done it a few times, so I get reasonably good. But I always end up changing it anyway. So see, swinging forward now. Here we go. Just slowly getting less and less of a swing. Okay, and they're getting a bit tighter as well. See the timing between these ones? And then maybe my last one is at 0. How good does it look? Who knows? Let's go and check. Spacebar. Okay, if it looks a bit not great, okay, make sure you add some easing first. So select all these keyframes, right click them, go to velocity. Okay, and let's go to 70. 70. Always looks good with a bit of easing, remember? Awesome. Add your own sound effects. That looks pretty cool. All right, and I'm going to save. Okay, not S, save. All right, so I've got my keyframes. Now I want to add them to all the different layers. Now, a couple of things. Just make sure your playheads at the beginning. Otherwise, it can cause problems. And instead of just dragging across and copying all these keyframes, because what you can do is just copy keyframes onto another layer. But if I select all this, can you see I'm selecting position and scale and all these sorts of things as well as this? So what I want to do is actually just click these guys. I can be real sneaky and try and select them in there, or just click the word X rotation and it selects all the keyframes and I can go edit, copy, copy. Okay, or Control C. I can twirl them up. Click on this layer, make sure my keyframe plays at the beginning, and I go paste, and then I go paste. Okay, and if I hit spacebar, look at these guys go. All right, so they're all going at the same time. Awesome. Now what I wanted to do is I want to stitch them together so they all kind of fly along. Now the big trick with this is if you have your playhead at the beginning, it's not going to work, or anywhere along here, you need to wait for them all to be finished. Okay, so move your playhead somewhere along here. Okay, and what we're going to do, it's all to do with parenting. Okay, so I want Walter to follow Daniel. Daniel's the lead. He's the first one to come down. And then I want my last name to follow. You go and follow the middle name there. So it's kind of like he's the start, then Water follows him, and then Scott follows him. Okay, so they follow each other, and watch this. Okay, is it beautiful? Look, it's okay. But what I would like to do is, so they're all following along. Okay, and what do I want to do? I would like to play with the timing. Okay, so they all kind of, so you all follow. Actually, let me show you what could go wrong if you don't have, if you do your parenting at a different time. Watch this. If you do your parenting kind of halfway, like at the beginning, okay, and you get Walter to follow Daniel, and you get Scott to follow Walter, look what happens. If that ever happens, it means that you didn't have your playhead further enough out. So I'm gonna undo until they were both flat. Okay, so the parenting's gone. Parenting's gone there. Okay, so just make sure your playhead's out here in the no man's land where they're all flat. Then do your parenting. So Scott follows Walter, and Walter follows Daniel. And you, my friends, are cool and flowing. Now, what I want to do is play with the timing. So just going to stretch these out so they don't all start at the same time. So watch this. It's kind of cool. It's a little bit jumpy. Okay, a little bit jiggly. So what you could do is I could select all of these, go to U. Maybe grab all of these, hold down my Alt key and just drag them out a little bit. Actually, I think I have to do it per layer. That's not cool. Now I'm just playing around. I should just leave them as is and we're happy. Now I'm gonna fiddle around and mess with my keyframes and probably wreck it. Let's just see. Is it better? Oh, it's not better. It's different. Okay, I'm gonna probably mess around this for ages. Yeah, it's kind of cool. I can't help myself, I'm sorry. It needs to look amazing. I need to impress you with my After Effects skills. Okay, I'm still not happy with it, but that's okay. To kind of add the last little bits to it is, we've done the easing. Okay, let's just check if that's the easing. So what have we got for the easing? Yeah, so the easing's kind of off, so that's it. So let's select this, let's right click them, and go to velocity. And can you do them all in one big go? Maybe. Oh, what did I click there? I'm not too sure. This could have been 70-70. Now look at it, let's go. It didn't help at all. Okay, so last things we can do to tidy this up, to make it a little nicer, is to turn motion blur on. So I'm gonna turn it on globally, and then I'm gonna turn it on for these three layers. It'll look a bit better, watch this. So it's kind of stressing my machine out a little bit. It actually looks a whole lot better longer. Okay, but anyway. It does look better. Okay, so easing, a bit of motion blur. And the last thing I'm gonna do is always the vignette. Always need a vignette. Go to File New, Adjustment Layer. We've done this in earlier videos, so I'm gonna skim through it. Okay, let me get your color, drag it onto your adjustment layers, go to vignette, go to amount, drag that to the left. Okay, and it's not working, I know why. Okay, because we've done it to the adjustment layer and it's affecting everything underneath. And there's a vignette being applied to these texts, but there's nothing actually behind you. There's white, but it's actually coming from my comp Remember, we made our comp here and comp settings, we made it white. Okay, so that's what's giving it its white, but the adjustment layer can't affect it. Essentially, this white is no man's land. It actually renders out black. It's just kind of a placeholder. So I'm gonna put it back to black. Okay, I should have done this at the beginning. And I'm gonna add a background layer. So I'm gonna go to layer, new, we're gonna use solid. This one here is gonna have a background color white. And even though it's gonna look exactly the same, let's get the layer order right, background, you at the back. Okay, it means that the vignette's got something to apply to, rather than just these kind of text. Awesome, that's my lovely vignette, that's my motion blur, and that is it for swinging text. All right, I'll see you in the next video.